Hello dear children, good morning. Today I'm going to start with the new lesson and the name of the lesson is A Fairy with Horns, written by Ruskin Bond. So, all of you open page number 28 children. Lesson 3, A Fairy with Horns, written by Ruskin Bond. So, before going to start the lesson, let us see the warm-up part. Work in pairs in this chart. So this is a chart. You have to work in pairs. As you are not in school at present, you have to work this with your parents. Okay. Work in pairs in this chart. List out the names of as many creatures as you can have as pets. So somebody will bring pets like dogs, rabbits, goats, sheep, cow, right? And even monkeys also. So you have to list out some names, as many as creatures as you can have as pets. Discuss with your partner why many people adopt unusual pets. So some people adopt unusual pets. So, you have to discuss and you have to fill this chart. Okay, children, let's begin the lesson. Though grandfather provided the household with as large as a variety of pets as one could wish for, my own favorite was the little black goat who followed me home from the mustard fields one day. So, here, this is the little black goat. This is the little black goat and this is the favorite. This was the favorite among as large as a variety of pets. This is the favorite one to the speaker. His grandfather provided him with household with as large as a variety of pets, but this black goat is the favorite. Each year before the monsoon rains came, the little Song River was a narrow stream. I liked wading. What do you mean by wading, children? Wading means walk with effort through water. Wading means walk with effort through water. Children, whenever you come for difficult words, you try to write the meanings when I told you, okay? I will tell the meanings and you have to write it down in your textbooks when you listen, when you come across different words. A difficult words, okay? So I liked wading. Wading means walk with effort through water. I liked wading across it and then wandering. Wandering. What do you mean by wandering, children? Wandering means traveling aimlessly from place to place. Traveling aimlessly from one place to another place. Through the fields and tea gardens, watching the men moving about among the yellow mustard and the women in their bright red saris picking tea. So, the speaker, whenever the monsoon rains came, the little Song River was a narrow stream. The speaker walked with effort through water and then he traveled aimlessly from one place to another place through the fields of the tea gardens. And he liked watching the men moving among the yellow mustard and women in their bright red saris picking tea at the tea garden. I had been sitting on the bank of a small irrigation canal gazing. What do you mean by gazing? Gazing means looking with great curiosity. So, he liked sitting on the bank of a small irrigation canal, looking with great curiosity at a couple of herons. What do you mean by herons, children? Large water birds. Yes, in this picture we can see we have large water birds in the canal. So, gazing means looking with a great curiosity at a couple of large water birds fishing in muddy water. So, this is all the muddy water and these we can see in this picture. So, these herons fishing in muddy water. So, this is the small fish, right? At a couple of herons fishing in muddy water, when I felt something bump my elbow. What do you mean by bump? Bump means a light blow. Okay. Looking around, I found at my side a little goat, jet black and as soft as velvet with lovely gray eyes. So this is, he has seen a little goat, jet black color and very soft, like a velvet, and it has a lovely gray color eyes. Neither her owner nor her mother was around. So her mother or her owner was not around. She continued to nudge. What do you mean by nudge? Nudge means push gently. Nudge means push gently. She continued to push gently him. Me means here speaker. So, I looked in my pockets for nourishment. Nourishment means children. Food necessary for growth, health and proper condition. The food that is necessary for a proper growth, proper health and a good condition is called nourishment. And finding a ginger biscuit. So, totally he put his hands in his pockets for food and finding a ginger biscuit, held it out to her. She ate it with relish. What is mean by relish? Relish means great enjoyment. So this goat ate the ginger biscuit with relish, with great enjoyment. Then sat down beside me and began nibbling at the grass. Nibbling means children, eat frequently in small amounts. So the goat then sat down beside the speaker and began eating frequently in small amount at the grass. A little later, when I got up to leave, the goat rose too. So, when the speaker, after some time, when the speaker got up to leave, the goat also rose. And when I started walking home, she followed me unsteadily. So, this goat followed him when he started walking to his home, her thin legs taking her this way and that. So, it is unable to walk properly, her thin legs taking the goat this way and that way. Go home, I said as she danced around me. So this little goat is dancing around the speaker and the speaker said go home. But she followed me to the riverbed. But she didn't want. She followed. The goat followed the speaker till the riverbed. It was obvious. What do you mean by obvious, children? Self-evident. So it was self-evident that her trembling means to shake with fear. Her trembling legs would not stand up to the current. So I took her in my arms and carried her across the stream. We can see the speaker took the goat on his hands and he is carrying the goat across the stream. When I set her down, she remained by my side, rubbing against my legs. So when He set her down. She still remained by the speaker's side. It is rubbing against his legs. What do you mean by rubbing, children? Rubbing means an action of a person or thing that rubs. I set out for home at a brisk. What do you mean by brisk? Brisk means quick. I set out for home at a quick pace, feeling sure that I would soon leave the little goat behind. But her legs were stronger than I had supposed. She came hopping along right up to the gate of her house. So the speaker thought that he set out for home at a quick pace, he felt sure that he would soon leave the little goat at the place. But the goat's legs were stronger than what the speaker thought, and the goat came hopping along right up to the gate of our house. Our house means speaker's house. There was nothing I could do but carry her in and present her to grandfather. So there is nothing to do. So he carried the little goat and he thought that he can present it to her grandfather. Not another pet, said grandmother when she saw the goat on the veranda lapping a saucer of milk. What do you mean by lapping, children? Lapping means to fold something over into itself. So, again another pet, grandmother said when she saw the little goat on the veranda while lapping a saucer of milk. I have told both of you again and again that I will not tolerate another animal in the house. So she is not able to tolerate. She doesn't want to see another animal in the house. She is saying to the grandfather as well as the speaker that she has already told that she is not able to tolerate another animal in the house. So children, you once go through the today's video and we will continue the remaining lesson in our next class, okay? You once go through the today's video and if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Bye children, thank you.